My message is to the non-aligned movement and the G77 plus China, focused on renewed international efforts for peace, financing for sustainable development and climate action, and the need for urgent reforms to our multilateral institutions.
The United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres has denounced Israel for the death of Palestinian civilians in Gaza and said it was unacceptable to oppose statehood for the Palestinian people. According to the Secretary General, the refusal to accept a two-state solution for Israelis and Palestinians and the denial of the right to statehood for the Palestinian people is unacceptable. He's concerned that the Israel-Palestine conflict might prolong, leading to the loss of more innocent lives.
Endless Israeli bombardment of Gaza in response to the horrific terror attacks by Hamas is the most intensely destructive campaign waged since I became Secretary General. The number of civilian casualties, including women, children, and our own staff, is unprecedented in such a brief period of time. It continues to rise, and hunger and disease are now adding to the toll. More than 100 days after 7 October, more than 100 hostages are still being held, and they must be released immediately and unconditionally. And I will not give up on calling for an immediate humanitarian ceasefire. That is the only way to end this nightmare for civilians in Gaza, facilitate the release of all hostages, and prevent the conflict from engulfing the entire region.
The UN chief also hinted on the need for Africa to have seats on the United Nations Security Council, giving hope that in the recent declaration by permanent member states, Africa is to be favored by at least one permanent seat. He expressed an urgent need to reform his council, explaining that currently it's paralyzed by geopolitical divisions and its composition does not reflect the reality of today's world.
Global institutions reflect the world that built them 80 years ago when many African countries were still colonized. They are no longer fit for purpose. Security Council is stuck in a time warp. How can we accept that it still lacks a single African permanent member? The global financial system is outdated, dysfunctional, and unfair. This September, the United Nations will convene the Summit of the Future with a focus on updating these institutions so that they align with today's world and respond to today's challenges, notably to the vital interests of developing countries.
His concern comes at a time when African member states during the 19th Non-Aligned Movement Summit that concluded yesterday renewed the push for at least two permanent seats on the United Nations Security Council. The Secretary General, Mr. Antonio Guterres, also addressed the summit, calling upon member states to live up to the expectations of the theme, leaving no one behind, at a time when many countries face political, social, and economic challenges.
New technologies can turbocharge progress towards the SDGs. Our proposed Global Digital Compact aims to ensure that in a new technological era, no one is left behind. So momentum for change must come from you. I urge you to keep driving these efforts forward. We have a chance to cultivate a just, peaceful, and prosperous future where no one is left behind. But for that, a lot needs to be changed and reformed. Together, let's unite to fight to make it a reality.
The Israel-Hamas war erupted on October 7th with a cross-border rampage by some 3,000 who killed some 1,200 people in Israel and abducted another 253 amid brutal atrocities. Israel launched an operation in Gaza in response aimed at destroying Hamas, toppling the terror group's regime in Gaza, and retrieved the hostages, 136 of whom are still believed to be in the terrorists' hands. This war has disrupted peace and security for both Palestinians and Israelis. Report by Jaliad Namwaya for the news.